All right, right now we're going to set the antlers on there. And I'll show you on the rack, you can see the three holes that I've put on there. Make sure your screw holes are angled right so they hit your baseboard on your mannequin. And make sure, obviously, they're going to, they're symmetrical and they're not sitting too far to one side. Make sure it's all lined up. That's how it's looking so far. We've got that nose tucked. And obviously that eye to the left is sagging there. But it's gonna come out real well. It's got a big neck on it. I'll show it from the side here. Big Indiana deer. Mass all the way out to the tips. It's a 13 pointer. And killed by Ross Huff. All right, what we're gonna wanna do now, we're gonna start bonduing the ears. And this is, you know, this is kind of a personal preference. A lot of people like to use ear liner, but your ear liners, you know, there's a lot of cutting involved and you have to get them all the way out to the edge, you know, so you don't get any shrinkage. I mean, you can put paste and you can even mix it in with Bondo over the, in the ear liner and spread it out. But I just like the Bondo, it's what I've always done. Get yourself a piece of cardboard here and get your Bondo first part on. And depending on how much you've done this, decides how much hardener you need to put in there. Now since I've done it quite a bit, I put enough in there to get it setting up fairly quick. But as you're working this, you cannot walk away from it. You've got to keep a form in the ear. So I'm going to put my hardener in here. Get that mixed up real well. Get it down in there and start pushing it, working it down. Make sure you get both sides of the ear. Okay, what you want to do, keep just, most of it's going to be up here in the top part of the ear. So you're going to want to work it all the way down throughout this, get all the air bubbles out, all the air bubbles you can, get them all out. And if you feel it kind of thick in some spots, move that Bondo over. And you should be able to tell in your hands where the Bondo, now you'll feel it. Push it all the way down to the tip here. Keep rubbing the Bondo throughout the ear. Make sure you can feel it. Keep working those bubbles out. And bring it up and look at the shape. Make sure it looks right. But do not walk away from this, because if you just leave it hang, it's going to dry exactly how it sits. So keep working it. You know, just to give you a visual, just to make sure, get down and look at it and make sure that drying the way you want it to. Keep working this, we'll do the other one, and get the ear muscles built up. So what we're going to do now that this Bondo started to dry, we are going to connect by sewing this part of the burr around the antler, this point from your incision, to the other point, all the way up here, so it wraps around the base of the antler. I'm going to go ahead and start sewing and bringing this together and give us a tight fit around the antler base. Okay, what we've done now is we have finished our ears and we have filled the empty space up with clay. What you want to do is get your molding clay. When you get behind the ear, you want to fill up this section of the earbud. This is something that a lot of guys they miss out on. To me, the ear muscle is one of the most defining features of a white-tailed deer. You don't see the ears just pop out of the head. And if you don't put enough clay in here, you'll run into some wrinkling problems when you get to sewing. When this is hanging down, you fill this up with clay and you build this up. You can use reference pictures really well on this part and get this ear, you know, turned, get its position. But I like to put a little groove right here to show that ear muscle. And you get your ears set in here, put a wire in the ear and use that to stabilize the ear as it dries. Okay, we're going to continue sewing on this deer. Any type of method that really locks in the hide is going to work. I use a mix between a baseball stitch and a running stitch. Anything that you can use that really locks in this hide and is going to make it move less is the best. You can see how much of the mannequin you can still hide. This is all going to come together, and what we'll do at the very end when we get all this sewn up, we'll take a piece of plastic, whether it be from like a milk jug or anything else. Take a piece of plastic and put tacks all the way up it, and it keeps the seam, not only does it keep it closed, but it keeps his hair down so you can't see a tuft sticking up after you get done sewing. Okay, when I sew, I get myself a loop like this, and I go in the loop once, in the loop twice, and then I go on the opposite side back through the loop, and then I pull. That'll draw your hide together. Be careful, don't cut yourself with your string that you're sewing with, because that'll happen and it's no fun. Alright, when you get to your Y here, you're going to have a lot of space down in here, so you want to fill that with clay and then put some hide paste on here. That way this sets and it's not sunken in. Once you get that built up, we'll put some hide paste, like I said. Just get some hide paste on a stick or whatever you got. Just slap it in there. There's something for it to grab onto. You can put it on the skin. We've got our string right here, and we're at the end of the Y, at the split in the Y. What I like to do, once I'm at the top, I put my next incision to connect it all right here at the tip of this pad. So it's going to draw right in here. Okay, we've got the ear set, the muscle structure how we want it, and we put wires in the ears, go through the ear into the mannequin, and that'll keep your ears set where you end up positioning the ears. We've stuffed a little bit of the tissue paper in the nose, just started forming it. And another thing, up here at the base of the antlers, a lot of people don't even do anything.
but I put brads. I push the skin really close up to the antler base and nail brads all the way around the base. That way, as it dries, the hair stays flush against the antler base. Just keep an eye on everything and make sure everything dries like you want it to. So, what we'll do is here in a couple weeks, we'll come back and we'll start painting this deer and finishing it and getting into the real detailed work. So, thank you for viewing this. And hopefully you've learned a little something from the process. Thank you.
I pulled into Nazareth, was feeling about half past dead. I just need some place where